Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you how you can push or pull a curved surface like this dome. First off, I want to give a big shout out to Jago for modeling this. It's pretty cool. Let me turn on the textures really quick so you guys can see it. Pretty cool. But what might happen in this is maybe you model everything and then you're like, oh, well, I want this to be bigger. And you can't do it. So at least by default, you can't do it. So if I select this and hit push pull, or if I try to move these, it, you know, deforms everything. And it's just super annoying. You might have to go through and like recreate all the geometry. But what I've gone ahead and done is installed a plugin called Joint Push Pull. It is, I believe, a Frito plugin. Yes, so you have to install Frito 6, and then you can install Joint Push Pull. And that's what this little bar is up here. Well, I'll have a link in the description below to where you can get Frito 6 and Joint Push Pull. They're on Sketchucation, but I'll have the direct links for that. So, you know, this is really super simple once you have that installed. The hardest part is actually getting it installed because you can't just go through the extension warehouse. But and I have another video which I'll link in the description that'll show you how to install extensions that you can't install through SketchUp. So you select the surface, and then what I want to do is I would like to essentially thicken the surface. So I'm just going to hit this. And then it's going to ask me to select the surface, and you can see like that, I can thicken the surface. Just enter, and that's it. So I was able to thicken that surface, really no big deal. If this video helped, please don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe, and as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.